Hello. So today's session we will discuss about code generation. So in that, first we discuss about introduction part of code generation. Then we discuss about issues related to code generator. So let me start the introduction part of our code generation. So the code generation is the final phase in our compiler model. Is the code generator. So it is our final phase of compiler model, and that phase is nothing but the code generator. So what it takes as an input and what it will give us as output. So it takes as input in the form of the intermediate representation called as IR, and that IR produced by the front end of the compiler. Along with that IR, it also takes symbol table information, and by using these two components, it produces as output. And that output is semantically equivalent to the target program. Hence, it is simply called keeping the target program, but having some semantic also. So simple, we define the code generation phase, nothing but a final phase of our compiler model, as well as it takes input in the form of the IR plus symbol table, and by using these two parameters, it converts into the target program. So the following diagram shows our the position of the code generator. The front end. People are already note about what is the front end and what is the input. So that front end produces the intermediate code. That intermediate code passes to the one of another phase is nothing but the code optimizer. And that code optimizer optimizes the given intermediate code and converts into optimized intermediate code. And that intermediate code we have to pass to the code generator phase. And that code generator phase gives us target program in the form of the machine code here. So the compilers that need to produce efficient target programs include an optimization phase prior to the code generation. The code generator phase optimizes the target program or optimize the machine code by using the help of a code optimizer phase here. And that code optimizer phase is prior to our code generation phase. So the optimizer maps is for the task of the code optimizer. So the code optimizer maps the intermediate representation into intermediate representation, which more efficient code can be generated. Means we just optimize the intermediate code, and that optimized intermediate code we have to pass to the code generator phase. In general, the code optimization and the code generation phase of compiler often referred to as a backend. Means the code optimizer and the code generator, these two phases we treated as a backend. So, which are the three major primary tasks for the code generator? As usual, first task for the primary for the code generator is instruction selection. Obviously, because we have to produce machine level language as the final output of our code generation, or we call it a total compiler model. So, which is the first task? Instruction selection means involves choosing appropriate target machine instruction to implement the IR statements. With the help of intermediate representation, we have to convert that intermediate representation into target machine instructions. So first task is nothing but we have to choose instruction, either CISC, RISC or the stack based. Then second task is nothing but register allocation and assignment. That also involves deciding what values to keep in which register, and that not keep which values we have to keep into register and which values we have to put into the memory part here. So that also have to for a primary task of our code generator is the register allocation and assignment. The third is nothing but the instruction ordering. It is also most important task because we have to decide what order to schedule the execution of the instructions. Means either the if there is a looping structure or we call it operations part there. So how we schedule that instructions, that also a primary task of our code generator. So the basic three major tasks is instruction selection is the first, second register allocation and assignment, and last is nothing but the instruction ordering. So next we have to discuss some issues related to the design of the code generator. Till we discuss about introduction part of our code generator, now we discuss about issues in the design of the code generator. So the first issue is nothing but input to the code generator. So input to the code generator is the intermediate representation of the source program produced by the front end. Already discussed that. Along with that intermediate representation, we have also input parameter is the symbol table. And that symbol table we have to use to determine the runtime addresses of the data objects denoted by the names in the IR. Means the objects which we denoted in the IR, that IR object, the addresses we have to require, and that addresses we have to store in the symbol table, and that addresses also we require here. So input to the code generator, intermediate representation, symbol table values. Second, many choices for the IR include thread address representations such as quadruples, triples, indirect triples. Means we just convert source language or the syntax added definition to intermediate representation by using thread address representation. That thread address representation, also called the code, we use thread address representation or by performing quadruples, triples, indirect triples. These are the some techniques by using the techniques we can start for intermediate representation. So also we assume that the function has scanned the past and translated the source program into relative global IR. This already scanning, parsing, as well as the translation of the source program is completely finished. So how to assume in code generator part. Also we have to assume that all syntactic and semantic errors have been detected. Means all kinds of errors also we have to remove from the source language. That is the necessary type checking as also finished, and that type conversion of operators have been also finished, as well as it also keep as well manner part. Means all error part as well as scanning, parsing, translated part is also finished, and that finished code will pass to our code generator. Means it is the input part. Next issue for the design of the code generator is nothing but the target program. So the instruction set we have to choose properly. So the instruction set architecture of the target machine has a significant impact on the difficulty of constructing a code generator that produces high quality machine. So for that purpose, we have to select the instruction set architecture. So there are three kinds of the instruction set architecture we are assuming here. The most common target machine instruction architectures are a RISC, reduced instruction set computer, CISC, complex instruction set computer, and last is nothing but stack based. So RISC means a reduced instruction set computer machine typically has many registers, three address instructions also there, simple addressing mode is there, and relatively simple instruction set architecture. People are known about what is the RISC as well as CISC. So in contrast of that RISC, there is CISC. CISC is a machine typically has a few registers. Two address code is our CISC three address code, there is two address code. The variety of addressing modes also there. Here is in our RISC simple addressing mode, here is variety. Several register classes also we have to use. Variable length instructions and instructional side effects. Means this is the CISC and RISC, as well as we discussed some difference between CISC as well as the RISC. And the third kind of instruction set structure is nothing but the stack based. In stack based machine, operations are done by pushing operands into a stack. Use the push and pop operations we require in stack based machine. We have to push the operands into the stack, and then performing the operation on the operands at the top of the stack, and then we have to perform the operations on the stack of the operands. So it is a stack based machine. So third issue is instruction selection. Means how we select the instruction. The nature of the instruction set of the target machine has a strong effect on the difficulty of instruction selection. For example, the uniformity and completeness of the instruction set are important factors. If the target machine does not support each data type in uniform manner, then is exception to the general rule requires special handling. Actually, if there is any error occur, also some supporting is not possible for the data type. So for that also we have to require exception handling. On some machines, for example, floating point operations are done using separate registers. Instruction speeds and machine idioms are either important factor for the instruction selection. If we do not care about the efficiency of the target program, instruction selection is straightforward. So it is our third issue, which is related to our design of code generator, is nothing but the instruction selection. So in that the instruction selection, we have to maximum focus for the uniformity and completeness of the instruction, as well as instruction speeds and some machine idioms related factor. types follows from selection bias. So four issues in the design of code generator is the register allocation. So key problem in the code generation is the deciding what values to hold in what register. This is the major key problem of the code generation is which value which hold into the register, because the register are the fastest computation unit in the target machine, but we usually do not have enough of them to hold values. Hold values we are not kept in the register. Is which values we have to keep into register is the key problem. Which values which have to keep into the memory. So this difference is nothing but our problem for the register allocation. That problem first we have to solve. Which value we have to keep into the register and which value we have to keep in memory. Why this? Because the register is the fastest computation unit, as well as it also having a small memory to hold the value. So instructions involving the register operands are inherently shorter and faster than those involving operands in a memory. So if you send utilization of register, we will utilize register the same. The use of registers is often subdivided into two sub-problems. Means our utilization of register will be divided into two sub-problems. First is the register allocation. From the register allocation, which we select the set of variables that will reside in the register at each point in the program. This part of the register allocation. The second register assignment, during which we pick the specific register that a variable will reside in. Means in register allocation, we have to select the set of variables, and the register assignment, we have to pick the specific register for our register allocation. So the third issue is register allocation. And last is nothing but the evaluation order. The order in which computations are performed can affect the efficiency of the target code. This means we have to make the order of computations, and that order should be affect the efficiency of the target code. However, picking a best order in the general case is difficult NP complete problem. Initially, we shall avoid the problem by generating code for the three address statement in the order in which they have been produced by the intended code generator. Means for the evaluation order purpose, we have to take help of the three address statement format, and by using the three address statement, so we properly maintain the order for instructions which we want to evaluate. So this is nothing but last issues for the design of the code generator is the evaluation part. Thank you.